Edward Heath has been an MP for 38 years. He was elected Prime Minister in 1970, but the coal miners' strike and the three-day week saw him shunted from power in 1974 to see a Labour government take over. Now he's more well known for his blistering attacks on the current government. Today he was back putting the cat among the pigeons at the party conference in Brighton, making a controversial speech against Mrs. Thatcher's stand on Europe.
This is a major movement towards the unity of Europe in every way. Now,
and he got another stormy reception. This stance of almost always being at odds with the Conservative government has had its effect down at Old Bexley and Sidcup, where there's a tussle going on amongst the Tory party faithful. In the blue corner is the throw-in-the-towel brigade.
There comes a time, you know, when you wonder what on earth he's got in common with us. I can't remember a single issue over many years in which he has spoken out in favour of the government he was elected to support, not on one single issue, and that strikes me as being terrible.
But there are some strong opponents in the other corner, led by John Titmuss. Even his home has taken on battle garb.
Mostly he speaks out. Everything is wrong. If a government policy is wrong, then he's not afraid to stand up and speak out against it. I mean, the petition that I've got signed by over 900 people, assigned by all different people, all different political parties. So, I mean, that stands for itself.
And despite what Councillor Pope says about Edward Heath...
It may well be that he would like to consider at the next general election standing down. I think that would be a wise decision on his part.
His supporters say he's doing a grand job. Paradoxically, a better job, they claim, than the Labour Party.
And I think he's doing a jolly good job putting forward the opposition point of view, because without the existence of any really effective opposition in the House of Commons at the moment, then Ted Heath's doing that job for us.
The controversy will continue, no doubt, keeping the ex-Prime Minister in the spotlight.